AEW have officially signed this free agent, and is this retiring WWE superstar having second thoughts? But first, All Elite Wrestling are reportedly on the brink of announcing a brand new weekly television show, Collision, which is said to be airing live on Saturday nights at 8 p.m. Eastern, starting on June 27th from the United Center in Chicago. The show has been described by Andrew Zarian of the Matt Men podcast as an A1 show, meaning it will be treated as an equal to AEW Dynamite, with it expected to have its own stars unique to the brand, most notably the returning CM Punk. With that said, now that a new show is heading to television screens soon, it looks like AEW was set to cancel one of their other shows as to potentially reduce the overall workload. According to the description of last night's episode on Fight, who air AEW Dark Elevation as part of their AEW Plus streaming service, the final episode would take place last night, and the description reads, "Don't miss the special and final episode of Elevation, it's Best of Elevation, airing on Fight. The episode is throwing it back to some of the best matches that have graced our Monday nights over the years." Dark Elevation would begin in March 2021 and features pre-taped matches that are recorded before live television tapings of the other shows, with it airing on both YouTube and Fight. There has been 115 episodes to date, although that run has now officially come to an end. This now leaves AEW's weekly schedule to include Dynamite on Wednesday nights, as well as Dark on Tuesday nights, with Collision set to join the lineup in just under 2 months' time. One of the hot debates between wrestling fans, pundits, and workers is the question of if modern wrestlers regularly take too many unnecessary bumps, risking not only themselves but their opponents for a lack of long-term gain. The argument against such a mindset typically comes from those with a more old-school background who believe in the storytelling aspects of the business to sell tickets, versus the new-school thinking of doing whatever it takes to get a pop, a this-is-awesome chant, and to ultimately go viral online. A similar argument can be had for and against the overuse of a hardcore wrestling style. Despite his age, AEW World Champion MJF finds himself heavily in the old school camp, with his more methodical approach to his ring work receiving heavy praise without the need to do flips and dives to get a reaction. MJF would take to Twitter this week to share a serious message to both performers and fans, calling for wrestlers to take care of themselves more, whilst asking fans not to demand danger as the baseline expectation. And Max would say, "The more wrestling fans become bloodthirsty for these dangerous feats in the ring, the more the wrestlers will hurt themselves trying to curry fans' favor. Wrestlers, the fans don't understand that at any given point we can be paralyzed from the neck down or even die from a maneuver as simple as a body slam. By the way, fans reading this, body slams hurt, every move hurts. They will keep moving the goalpost of what they deem is good. So before you do something stupid, consider this, their tweet about your banger gonna pay for your medical bills, do the right thing. Go in the ring with the intention of winning the match and leaving the ring the same way you entered it." Last week on AEW Dynamite, Wardlow would become the new TNT champion after his win over Powerhouse Hobbs, this after aligning with Arn Anderson to balance out the interference from QT Marshall. Speaking on his Grilling JR podcast this week, AEW announcer Jim Ross would reveal that he believes both Hobbs and Wardlow could be the foundation of the company going forward, this when he listed the wrestlers that he felt could carry the company one day, and JR would say, "Wardlow comes to mind, quite frankly and quickly. I think Wardlow is good. I think that Powerhouse Hobbs has got a great upside in the future. He's got a great look, wonderful attitude. Those are two guys we just saw wrestle here a while back, a week or so ago, with Wardlow winning the TNT title back. I think both those guys have a chance to be two of the big foundation pieces in AEW if Tony Khan, as he's known, decides to go that way. They're both very good. They're both young. They're big, strong, athletic. I really enjoy working with both of those guys. There's rarely a television that goes by that I don't spend some time talking to both those guys. Not necessarily together, but where we have a little conversation about how things are. They'll ask me questions about the last match they had that they thought I might have seen, and I've pretty much seen them all. So I think those two guys are the likely candidates. Are they the only candidates? Probably not, but they're at the top of the list." And next, according to a report from PW Insider, WWE superstar Braun Strowman is currently out of action, with it believed that he suffered from an injury last Friday on SmackDown. The report notes that the monster is out with concussion issues and says, Former WWE Universal Champion Braun Strowman is currently out of action after suffering a concussion, multiple WWE sources have confirmed. Strowman was scheduled for this past weekend's live events, teaming with Ricochet against the Viking Raiders, but was pulled from the road in order to heal. He wrestled the Raiders with Ricochet on the 421 edition of SmackDown, so the injury must have occurred there. Strowman himself would soon take to Twitter to confirm that he is out of action, although he didn't specifically mention a concussion, and he would write, "Thank you to everyone that has reached out. I am doing much better. Hate missing work. Sorry to everyone over the weekend that was looking forward to me performing. We are taking every proper step to make sure I recover to 100%. Nothing can stop the monster. Much love." Next up, a recent All Elite Wrestling signee has been revealed, as according to Fightful Select, Ashley Dambois, who was a regular on AEW Dark, was reportedly offered a contract back in February. The report confirms that Ashley did indeed sign the deal, which explains why she's been making exclusive appearances for AEW since mid-March. In addition to those AEW appearances, she's also wrestled on Ring of Honor television, most recently taking part in a Proving Grounds match against Athena on the April 7th episode. AEW has been actively signing free agents lately, with Switchblade Jay White and Commander being among those recent signees who faced off on last week's episode of AEW Dynamite. Last year, WWE Hall of Famer Edge would hint that he plans on retiring later this year in the summer when the company returns to his hometown of Toronto, Canada, the perfect setting where he to actually hang up his boots. With that said, it looks like the rated R superstar is beginning to second guess himself, as this week on Logan Paul's Impulsive podcast, Edge would reveal that he may have a little more left in the tank. When addressing the fact that he is closer to the end of his career than he is to the start, he would say, "I don't want to stick around to the point where it's like, oh, there he is, okay. I don't want to get there. When I come out now, I feel the explosion. I feel all of that to throw at them. That's still there. I don't know if that, for me, will ever go away. I feel like in this last run, the Rocky Balboa movie, which I watched 2 nights before my comeback, I was in tears. Sylvester Stallone's monologues in it were all things that were going through my mind. I realized I got to get this out of the basement because I didn't have the chance to end it the way I wanted it to. This time, I'm going to get to do that. Now I have 2 little girls that I have to spend the rest of my life taking care of. I have a wish list of things that are still to do, but it's not long and neither is the time. At most, I might have another year in me to be able to do it at this level and still be able to do it at an elite level where I can still hang, or after getting with Austin Theory, who is 25 and wasn't born when I had my first match in WWE. For what it's worth, Edge's WWE contract is believed to be up at some stage this year, with its original expiry date being in January. The date was then seemingly extended due to time missed with injury. His use of the term elite run has led to online speculation that he could be set to join his former tag partner Christian in All Elite Wrestling, although I wouldn't take this too seriously and just take it with a pinch of salt for now.